Okay, and here's Mark, and here's Abby. Now, let's see, can we, no.
Hi, Priscilla and Carlos.
Hi, hi. It is a pleasure.
Hello.
Hello, Chris. Hi. Good evening.
How are you?
Many people.
Hello.
Many.
I mean, they're all over the world.
Carlos and I met in Paz.
Oh, cool.
Yay. Carlos is from Brazil.
Oh, good.
It's a pleasure.
Me also.
Well, we'll see Katrina in a little bit. There's Paul. I haven't seen Liz's face yet.
Go across, you get there.
I already have. Oh, okay. I went all the way to the end.
Oh, okay.
Now I was going back to the beginning.
Hello, welcome everybody. We're glad that you're here. We are going to get started here in the next minute or so. We've got a lot of moving pieces, several different people from different parts of the world will be sharing with us, and then also we'll have some videos to share as well. I am Nathan Wheeler, and I'm the coordinator of Youth and Young Adult Ministries for the denomination. So if I don't know you, it's nice to meet you. Hello. I will try my best to stay out of the way, but since we do have several people who are doing different things, it might get a little convoluted at times. It probably won't go super smooth like everybody's Christmas services does, but I think it'll be great and wonderful, and it's so good to see everyone and to be together on this Christmas Eve. A few notes. We would love to see your face, but once the service starts, we would prefer if you would mute your mic. That way, it will stay focused on the people who are speaking and it won't pop over to your video, since we want to see the people who are talking. I will do my best to highlight the people who are talking so we're not staring at gallery view, but you can switch back and forth on your own screen if you want to see which view you want. You just hit the view in the top right-hand corner or at the bottom. It should have a notion to do that. But I will be sometimes pinning people or highlighting their videos. So know that nothing is wrong with your Zoom. It's just I'm trying to make sure that people see who's speaking and be able to follow that. It's okay if you don't hear a video or don't see a video or something like that. Just let me know in the chat. That way I can correct it. Like I said, it might not go super smooth, but we're all here and it's going to be wonderful, and it's good to see you on this Christmas Eve. I am getting ready to start our service. So again, if you would just mute if you are not speaking right now, that would be helpful, and we will get started.
Trinity and Paul and Gideon.
Okay, I am assuming now you're seeing a video, so I'm hopeful that that is happening, and we're going to get started.
Baby boy would one day walk on water. sight to a blind man. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hands? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of
Our call to worship is from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. They live in a land of shadows, but no light is shining on them.
We are here because God's promise to our ancestors came true when Jesus was born. God will keep the promise to come again in glory. We light this candle to proclaim the coming of the light of God into the world. With the coming of this light, there is hope. Because of Christ, we not only have hope, but we believe that good is stronger than evil. God wants us to work for good in this world.
Let us pray. Oh God, we thank you that you brought hope into our world. By the good news of the Bible, you are still bringing hope to the people. Help us to be ready to welcome Jesus Christ so that we may think good thoughts and do good deeds, and so that we may be a people of hope in our world. Amen.
We gather around the Advent wreath today, knowing that we are not perfect, that we all make mistakes and do bad things. Only Jesus obeyed God fully. Jesus helps us to live as God wants us to live. Jesus gives us peace. We light this candle to proclaim the coming of the light of God into the world. With the coming of this light, there is peace. For Christ is called the Prince of Peace. Christ's name is also Emmanuel, God with us. The presence of Christ with us gives us peace day by day. Eternal God, we thank you that through all the years you have given peace to your people. Help us to have your peace in our lives. We pray that in this Advent season, we may, by what we do, show your presence to the sick, to the hungry, and to the lonely, so that they too may have peace. Amen.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us at this time. We're part of El Grupo, and we meet here at Faith Cumberland Presbyterian Church in Bartlett, Tennessee. Thank you for joining us at this time, and we will be lighting up the third candle, which is the candle of joy. So we'll call Juan to light up the candle for us at this time. Now, Lady will be doing the reading for us in Spanish for today.
Pronto celebraremos el nacimiento de Jesús. Adoramos a Dios con alegría en nuestros corazones. Recordamos las palabras que el ángel dijo en ese primer día de la Navidad. He aquí, te traigo buenas noticias de gran gozo que vendrán a todo el pueblo. Encendamos esta vela para proclamar la venida de la luz de Dios al mundo. Con la llegada de esta luz, el gozo y la alegría que es nuestra no solo en Navidad, sino siempre.
Soon we shall celebrate the birth of Jesus. We worship God with joy in our hearts as we are reminded of the words the angel said on that first Christmas day. Behold, I bring you good news of great joy which will come to all the people. We light this candle to proclaim the coming of the light of God into the world. With the coming of this light, there is joy. Joy that is ours not only at Christmas, but always. Now, let us all pray together. O Holy One, as Christmas draws near, there is a sense of excitement in the air. We can feel a joy in our lives and see it in those around us. Still, for some of us, this is a sad time because of unhappy things that have happened in our lives. Help us to have the joy that does not depend on earthly happiness, but on you. Help us to be filled with your joy so that we may share it with a joyless world. Amen.
De oração e de corações abertos quando cantamos canções de alegria.
Now we light the final candle. Wow. Now we light the final candle in our Advent wreath. The Christ candle, the candle which reminds us of God's grace. In lighting the Christ candle, we celebrate Jesus Christ, the greatest gift who makes all of these other gifts possible.
Let us pray. We thank you, God, for your gift of Jesus Christ to the entire world. We thank you that Christ's coming makes hope, peace, love, and joy possible for every person in every nation. Encourage us to do our part to bring goodwill and peace to our families, our churches, our neighborhoods, and to the entire world. Now let your Spirit put us in touch with you, the living God, through the words and music we hear tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
You can go watch with Dad, whatever you can say here.
Thank you.
dias, foi publicado um decreto de César Augusto, convocando toda a população do Império para recensear-se. Este, o primeiro recenseamento, foi feito quando Quirino era governador da Síria. Todos iam alistar-se, cada um à sua própria cidade. José também subiu da Galileia, da cidade de Nazaré, para a Judéia, à cidade de Davi, chamada Belém, por ser ele da casa e família de Davi, a fim de alistar-se com Maria, sua esposa, que estava grávida. Estando eles ali, aconteceu completarem-se os dias, e ela deu à luz o seu filho primogênito, enfaixou e deitou numa manjedoura, porque não havia lugar para eles na hospedaria. Havia naquela mesma região pastores que viviam nos campos e guardavam seu rebanho durante as vigílias da noite. E um anjo do Senhor desceu aonde eles estavam, e a glória do Senhor brilhou ao redor deles, e ficaram tomados de grande pavor. O anjo, porém, lhes disse: não tenham medo, eis aqui vos trago boa nova de grande alegria, que será para todo o povo. É que hoje vos nasceu na cidade de Davi o Salvador, que é Cristo o Senhor. E isso vos servirá de sinal: encontrareis uma criança envolta em faixas e deitada em manjedoura. E subitamente apareceu com um anjo uma multidão da milícia celestial, louvando a Deus e dizendo: glória a Deus nas maiores alturas, e paz na terra aos homens a quem ele quer bem.
Amém. It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch the harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from hands our gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. And ye beneath life's crushing load, whose forms are bending low, who toil along the climbing way with painful steps and slow, look now for bread and golden hours come swiftly on the way. Oh, rest beside the weary road and hear the angels sing. For lo, the days are hastening on, by prophet bards foretold, when with the ever-circling years comes round the age of gold, when peace shall over all the earth its ancient splendors fade, and the whole world give back the song which now the angels sing.
Mark.
Yes. Mark,
jump yes. the gun.
Oh.
You're a little early, but it's all good. We're going to come back to you here in a few minutes. Patrick, why don't y'all read your scripture, and then we'll do the song. And then after that song, Mark, it'll be communion.
Okay, tonight reading for us in Colombia is Marianne and Raul. And they're going to be reading in English and Spanish. And they're representing the new church development in Rio Negro, Colombia.
Okay. Hello, everyone. This is the reading from the book of Tune, verse 15 through 20. I'll be reading first and then my wife Mary after. And it says, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Sucedió que cuando los ángeles se fueron de ellos al cielo, los pastores se dijeron unos a otros, pasemos pues hasta Belén y veamos esto que ha sucedido y que el Señor nos ha manifestado. Vinieron pues apresuradamente y hallaron a María y a José y al niño acostado en el pesebre. Y al verlo dieron a conocer lo que se les había dicho acerca del niño. Y todos los que oyeron se maravillaron de lo que los pastores le decían. Pero María guardaba todas estas cosas, meditándolas en su corazón. Y volvieron los pastores glorificando y alabando a Dios por todas las cosas que habían oído y visto, como les había dicho.
Table from all places and all spaces, whether in churches, buildings, homes, or in our community, God calls us to this, God's table, a table full of grace. And there is abundance here at God's table. So if you are fearful, come to this table to be made new in love. If you are doubtful, come to this table to be made strong in faith. If you are lonely, come to this table to find comfort and community. Come wherever you are, however you are, to this God's heavenly feast. Come and partake, for this is God's table set for you, God's people.
Let us go to God in prayer. Oh Lord, you are amazing. You have been fashioning and forming all your creation from the very start. From the beginning, you saw the good that you were creating. You also knew how we need you, and you stuck with us. We have tried to do things our way. We have been distracted. There have been times when all we could do was argue and wrestle with you. There have also been times when we were too blind to see you, too deaf to hear you, too bound up to feel you, and hurting so badly that we did not know how to reach out to you. And you stuck with us. Therefore, we praise you. You are holy, Lord. Gracious God, in Christ, you showed us how you work. Born in humility, he came to rule over all. Helpless as an infant, he showed the power of your love. Poor in things of the world, he brought the wealth of your grace. Rejected by many, he welcomed all who sought him. In dying and in rising, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. Therefore, we say thank you, and we offer our very selves to you to be a living and holy sacrifice dedicated to your service. So pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and juice, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the holy sacrament that you have given to us, a gift that points us to you. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, that we may be one with all who share this feast, united in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. Empower us by your Spirit, O God, to be Christ's presence in the world, even as Jesus was God with us. Give us courage to speak your truth, to seek your justice, and to love as you have loved us. Keep us faithful in your service until Christ comes in final victory, and we shall feast with all your saints in the joy of your eternal realm. Gracious God, you promise to hear all of our prayers, both spoken and unspoken. Hear us now as we come together as your church, praying the prayer that your Son taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive others. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
On the night of his arrest, Our Lord Jesus was at table with his disciples, and after giving thanks, he took the bread, broke it, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
In the same way, he took a cup and said, and gave thanks and said to them, "This cup is the cup of the new covenant, sealed in my blood, shed for the forgiveness of sin. Every time you drink of it, do this of me." And drink of this cup, we proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord Jesus Christ until he comes again. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
Let us pray together. Holy and gracious God, wherever we are, you are with us. May this meal of bread and cup serve to nurture us and fulfill us wherever we are. And at this table, we have come together as your children. Strengthen us as we go from here. And in the next few days, as our waiting comes to an end and we celebrate the coming of your precious Son, may we see the hope, joy, love, and peace that you share with your people now and always. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for joining us for this worship experience. We're so glad to be able to share this time with all of you. Now, may the grace of God, the love of Christ, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, abide in each of us now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you and Merry Christmas.
Thank you, everybody. Merry Christmas. Have a good holiday wherever you are. Thank you so much.
Thank you all for coming. This was a lot of fun. I'm glad everyone was able to come out.
Thank you, everybody.
Next time this year, we can all meet up in person.
Yeah, we'll all get together.
Yes.
It's going to be great.
Thank you, Paul, for the idea.
You're welcome. Thank you all for helping out. This was a lot of fun, and I'm really thankful for everyone that came and worshiped and you know, helped.